20th season. Raise your hand if you were at the first show. Wow. Oh my gosh. You guys too? Yeah, I think so. Who would have thought, right? This year's production is a Baja chorus line. And after much thinking about what a show I was going to do for the 20th, I thought, perfect, something that requires 20-year-old dancers. So anyway, no, but it is about people auditioning and telling their stories and about how we're all special and unique, but also part of a line, a chorus line that goes on whether we're here or not. So these are all things that this play gets us to think about for ourselves. Turn off your cell phones. Read your programs. I put a lot of work of writing into it, in those. And they don't let me say all the stuff that I would say, but it's in those programs. So tonight when you have your glasses and your little light, you can read those programs. The choreography from this is from the original chorus line, Broadway production. And that's amazing because we have 10-year-old up to almost 90-year-old doing some semblance of the choreography. What else? Turn off your cell phones. Whose seats are these? Please don't be shy. These are the best seats in the house. Come claim your seat. Come on down. Anyway, enjoy the show. Come, yay. Okay, take your seat. Okay, not at all. Okay, take, no. Okay, that'll add 2 minutes to our show. No, enjoy the play. We have a great cast, musicians, and choreographers.
Combination again, facing away from the mirror. 5, 6, 7, 8. groups now. Special talents, let's see what you can do. Don't kill yourself. I'm going to put you in your groups now. When I call out your number, come forward.
Oh, God, I can't remember my number.
When I find a person without a number, that will be you. Okay, girls first. Number 152. Number 179. Number 2. Number 149 downstage. And number 23 upstage. 23, Celeste?
23.
Stage left, girls. Second group. Number 27. Number 9 downstage.
Yes.
Number 24 upstage. 131.
I hope I get it. How many people does he need? God, I hope I get it. I hope I get it. How many boys, how many girls?
I really need this job. Please, God, I need this job. I've got to get this job.
Boys, number 44. Number 14, number 5. Okay, guys, special talents.
I can roll my R's.
Oh, really?
Eric on Eric Cigarro. Eric on Eric Barril. Rápido Ruwait en los carros. Cargado de azúcar. A ferrocarril.
And you.
Oh. Mouth trumpet.
Okay. One line from past Baja Shakespeare shows.
I'm an evil wizard. Princessa number 12. You have now reached the seventh plateau, and this is your final question. What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith that forged a sword that killed the beast?
Speak now, O evil wizard!
Ha 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 ha! One line from past Baja Shakespeare shows.
Liberty, liberty, boo! I'm two!
I know that one.
If it were done, 'twere well it were done quickly.
Very good.
I've got one.
Quiet! I am the queen, and what I say, you must obey.
Damn right. Anyone else?
Double, double, toil and trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble.
Okay, then. Thank you very much. First group of dancers. Five, six, seven, eight. Hold it, stop. Sheila, do me a favor. You dance further upstage and you downstage. Yeah. Okay. Five, six, seven, eight. Sheila, do you know the combination?
I knew it when I was in front.
I really blew it. How could I do a thing like that?
Girl in blue, still too much tension, face, neck, and shoulders. Relax. Okay, second group of girls. Five, six.
Hold it. I think I know the steps, but could you have someone do it in front, please?
Camilla!
Yeah?
Would you please do us the honor and do the combination in front, please?
No, you gotta be kidding. My job's done. I get to sit back and relax and watch now.
Get off your butt. You're still working. Come on up here. Come on.
Hold this.
Five, six, seven, eight. Okay,
two, please?
Ginger?
Do I get a raise?
Oh, come on. What's with the attitude? Why don't you give some of the other kids a chance? You already got the job. A 5, 6, 7, 8. First group of boys. Five, six, seven, eight. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, stop, stop. You, any jazz?
No.
Don't dance, don't dance, don't dance. Ginger, show me.
Oh, did I roll my eyes out loud?
You, chewing gum, get rid of it.
Okay, step, cross, step, kick, step, cross, step, kick.
Okay, got it? 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey, hey, listen, that's really good. You're doing all right. Just stay in the formation, okay?
I was born in Frankfurt, Germany, and moved to Arizona when Daddy finished his Air Force tour. I got really bored at college and headed to New Orleans with a girlfriend for the Mardi Gras, where I met Hans, our former lighting guru, who sure lit me up and became the love of my life. I have always loved to dance, and I did a short gig as a go-go dancer in New Orleans. Well, all that crazy movement damaged my knee, and this spring I'm having a full replacement knee.
Come back next year, and you can be a Baja Shakespeare hottie, darling.
Thank you.
Okay, let's see. You.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Me?
Name and age.
My name is Jana, but do you think I'm really going to tell you my age?
Go on, Jana.
All right. I was born on a leap year, so let me think. That makes me still a teenager. Oh, and by the way, what you don't know about me, these are real.
Good to know. You can make a note of that.
Yes.
And you. Yeah, you. What? With the guitar.
Huh?
Nate.
Before you interrupt, Doc, I was just asking Jerry a very important question.
What's that?
Well, he wanted to know if I had any weed on me.
All right, let's see, you. Any Baja shows?
No, this is my first one.
Well, isn't that special? I need someone with experience. Kiki, Baja shows.
Midsummer Night's Dream. Merry Wives of Windsor, As You Like It, Much Ado About Nothing, Twelfth Night, Taming of the Shrew, Comedy of Errors, Pericles, Mighty Rod, and of course Cinderella.
Jeez, show off.
No kidding.
And then Aloha, Snow White, Robin Hood, a Baja Shake Up, and last year, The Sea Princessa.
I've danced cumbia, my specialty, in more than 30 quinceañeras, from Las Cuevas to Boca de Alamo, including Buenos Aires. Locally, I'm known as Don Luis, el rey de cumbia.
What is cumbia?
It's like salsa, but older and slower.
Louie, how the hell old are you?
Well, I'll have you know, I'm comfortably under 90.
Shit, Louie, you're too old for a chorus line. In fact, you're too old for pickleball. You dinky don't dink anymore.
Damn, that's the truth. I know what I'm gonna do. I'll start a club for us old geezers, where we'll discuss the joys of regular movements. And I don't mean dance ones.
Okay. I'm eliminating down. When I call out your number, please form a line, girls first. Number 24. Number 9. Number 81, 149, 152, number 2, number 23, Celeste, right?
Yes.
Number 10, number 179, and Cassie. Other girls, thank you very much for coming. No, I'm sorry.
So much for having real boobs.
Okay, boys. Number 63. Number 84. Number 43. Number 44. Number 17. Other boys, thank you. Ginger,
I'll be back.
I think I got it. I think I got it. I knew he liked me all the time.
I want your pictures and resumes, please.
Still, it isn't over. It isn't over. I can't imagine what he wants. God, I hope I get it. I hope I get it.
Pictures and resumes, please.
Who am I anyway? Have I my resume? That is a picture of a person I don't know.
What does he want from me? What should I try to be? So many faces all around. And here we go.
I need this job. Oh God, I need this show.
Today, I want you to tell me your stage name. Your name is different. And I'd like to know where you were born and how you ended up in Baja Shakespeare. And something people do not know about you.
Terrific.
Oh, fabulous.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Celeste.
Do we have to? I mean, it isn't polite to ask a lady personal questions.
That is true, but that does not interest me in the least bit. Okay, then. With that being said, let's go down the line. Let's see. Let's start on the end. Stage right!
Okay, well, let's see. My name is Lola Fuentes. I'm from New York. Let's see, what can I tell? Oh, I know. I used to be a professional athlete. That's right, a circus performer. Oh,
It was amazing. We would travel the world performing for audiences. And then one year we came here to work at the Festival de Artes. And while visiting your really lovely, slightly dusty town, I met amazing people, like my friend, Rose, who taught me about pickleball. Well, you can imagine what happened next. I ran away from the circus to join pickleball. I am crazy about pickleball. You know, Ginger, like really crazy. But I miss performing. The stage is my first true love.
Circus performer, huh? That's a new one. All right, Lola, let's see what you got.
Awesome. Okay, Ellie, hold my shirt. Hard, but I know my flute hooping is a little bit crazy, but that is insane. I am a professional, Ginger. I can't work for free. I'm really sorry. I gotta go. Oh, thanks, Ellie.
Well, really miss having you, Lola, but see you at yoga on Saturday.
Okay, see you in yoga. Good luck, kids.
Okay, Seth, moving on. Seth, I'm Bill Barber. I eliminated you, Ginger.
Yet. I'm Bill Barber. My stage name is William Devon. That's a tribute to Shakespeare. And I'm an actor.
Oh, an actor. Well, I need singers and dancers.
Zach, I was born in Hollywood, California. And I know Baja Shakespeare. And I've been in 9 shows. And I went to night school and I studied to be a lawyer. Now, those guys can really act.
Like I said, I need singers and dancers.
Zach, I don't sing and I don't dance.
And you don't work for me. Next!
My name is Ron Heinen and I'd like the male lead. I'm from New Mexico. And when I was a kid, I was lucky enough to have my mother get tickets to the local theater through the TV station where she worked. That's where the love of theater began for me.
And Kim, good to see you. Tell me about yourself.
My stage name is Kiki La Joie de Vivre, at your service. I live full-time in Los Bariles, and Shakespeare is my main man. I have been with Baja Shakespeare for 20 years, and I have had a lot of leads. Men, women, and fairies, Now, in this next upcoming production of A Midsummer Night's Chorus Line, I would like to audition for the lead of Oberon, King of the Fairies.
You can't play a man.
I played Oberon in 2006. Well, go thy way. Thou shalt not from this grove till I torment thee for thy injury.
Get you gone, you dwarf, you minimus of Hendry Knotgrass maid, you bee, you acorn.
I played Hermia in 2013.
Enough already. I too live in LB full time and love my main man Shakespeare.
Yeah, but I could play bottom. Oui, monsieur, hee-haw, hee-haw. Or I could play Puck. If we shadows have offended, think but this, and all is mended.
Listen, I played lead men and fairies too.
Yeah, but I can dance. Every chance I get, I can do double time. Hit it, Jerry!
Give me a break.
Oh, please? Give me a break?
Any special tricks?
Yes. I can do accents. Où est la bibliothèque? La guerre de Lyon, c'est là-bas.
Salad bar.
Yes, but the audience, she likes me better. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Any song you can sing, I can sing softer.
I can sing any song softer than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
You're a little liar. I can kick higher.
I'm a cuter girl. I can do a twirl.
I can shake my salsa hips.
Is that all you got?
Yeah.
Give it a shot.
Any role you can play, I can play brighter.
I can play any role brighter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Oui, je peux.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can build stages.
I can sell tickets.
I can throw parties.
I can karaoke.
I can do most anything.
Can you make tamales?
No.
No, neither can I.
Yeah, but Connie makes a mean chicken parm, though.
Thank you,
Kiki.
La joie.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Ellie, and I'm 10, and I already know all the dances, lines, and songs for the show. In fact, I could even direct it if you got sick. Next! My only conflict is, school.
Speak up! I cannot hear you!
School! But you could write a note to excuse me if you want to, so I don't fail? Sir.
Zach. Oh, Dave. You couldn't know this, but I cut my acting teeth with Baja Shakespeare under the direction of the famous Bob and Leslie Currier. They saw I had talent. They kept me around, so should you.
So, they gave you a good line with speaking parts?
Yes. In my first play with them with speaking parts, I was given the Look, He Can Fly award at the closing party for delivering those lines well, kind of flapping my eyes and my arms and everything, and it went like this. Oh, monstrous! Oh, strange! We are haunted! Pray, masters, pray. Fly, masters, fly!
Help! This is wasting everybody's time. Next!
Hi, I'm Donna Julio, and I've always wanted to be taller. And I love to dance. Cassie, she's the one that told me about the audition.
Zach, can we speak for a moment?
Sure, go ahead.
Well, I mean privately.
Not now, Cassie. I'm running about an hour behind.
Well, I understand, but,
Next! Rocco!
Howdy. My name's Roberto, but my friends call me Rocco. I grew up in the mean streets of Salt Lake City, Utah. Managed to get through high school and a couple of years of college. Then I enlisted in the Marine Corps, Semper Fi. After that, I kicked around some, ended up in San Francisco. Peace. Love. I met a Chicago girl there and we got married. We had a couple of great kids, and after they were grown and out of the house, we split up. Later on, I met an angel in Wilson, Wyoming. We bought property in Los Bariles. We built our home here, moved to Baja Sur full time. Always been kind of a ham, and a couple of years ago, I signed on with Baja Shakespeare. I played a gangster and a knight. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn, and a king. I've been up and down and over and out. I'll say one thing. Each time I've found myself flat on my face, I've picked myself up and got back in the race. That's life. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. Baja Shakespeare. These vagabond shoes are longing. City blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it, Baja Shakespeare. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, Baja.
Robin Hood, Sheriff of Avon, lots of lines, lots of stage time.
I beg your leave, sire, for I have a thief to catch, and the sun doth move like a chariot pulled by some furry little animal.
You blew your mind!
Yeah. He's not the only one who's blown line in the Baja Shakespeare play.
I blanked out. I was a deer in the headlights.
Next.
Can you guess the name of this show?
Eole!
No, man. This is Snow White and the Seven Mariachis. Baja Shakespeare, man, way off the wall. This ain't your regular stuff, dude. It's what you need in this production, and I can help you.
How can you help me? You don't sing and you don't dance.
Let me think about that. Next.
Ginger, I gotta say this about Mr. Intrepid here. He doesn't give up. Do you You think you can teach him one of the dance numbers?
Oh, it would be easier to teach a corpse to dance. Come on.
Sure hope you got the magic for this girl.
Gonna take a lot of magic.
Okay, next, Sheila.
Yes? You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
Talk.
Well, okay, I'll start with my name. I'm Sheila Black, but everybody calls me Sassy. You can get my age from my Social Security card. I was born in Moline, Illinois, but I got out of there as soon as I could, honey, because I didn't want to be working on a farm or assembly line making tractors for John Deere.
Sheila, come down stage.
Can I sit on your lap?
You always come on like this?
Oh, no. Sometimes I'm aggressive. Actually, I'm a Leo.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months of the year better watch.
Yeah.
I'm very strong, honey.
Maybe too strong?
Am I doing something you don't like? I mean, you did tell me to be myself.
Just bring it down.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Why did you come here?
Well, I was tired of the hassle of New York, where I was trying to make ends meet as a dancer and being damn cold 6 months out of the year.
What drew you to the theater?
Honey, I already told you I was born in Illinois.
And don't perform, just talk.
And I wanted to shine and be the best that I could be. Isn't this exciting? Hey, look, my parents, they worked hard. They're good people. They really are. But I wanted more. I wanted the lights. I wanted the laughter. I wanted the applause. I mean, the first time I went on stage, it was just a lark, you know. But when that curtain went up, I had the power of being the center of attention. No longer was I Sheila Black, living in an apartment above the drugstore. I mean, anything to get out of the house.
What?
Nothing.
What did you say?
I said anything to get out of the house.
Why?
The truth?
Sure, you're strong enough.
Well, let's face it. My family scene, it wasn't all that great. My parents, they lost our home in a bad real estate deal, and they went to drinking. And when I got the lead in the high school play, The Bad Seed, they couldn't bother to interrupt their cocktail hour to come see me. So even though I had a crowd there giving me a standing ovation, I guess I'm still looking for my parents' applause.
Are you available for the posted show dates?
Oh, honey, I'm always available.
Okay, thank you, Sheila. I want to hear from Rose now. Go on.
Go on? What? Oh, you want to know how tall I am, the color of my eyes, or how many shows I've been in? I just gave you my picture and my resume, and everything you want to know is right there.
I know. Now tell me what's not.
Like what?
Like talk about yourself.
Like about what?
Well, tell me about pickleball.
Well, what's there to tell?
Why'd you take it up?
Retirement drove me to dink.
What made you want to perform at Baja Shakespeare?
Oh, who knows? I like to sing, and I was bored. I wanted to meet new people. Hey, if you want to know if I can sing. I'll perform. But I can't just talk. Please, I'm too nervous.
Then relax, Rose.
Look, I really don't mind talking, but I just can't now. Please, later.
You do want this job, don't you?
Sure, I want the job.
All right, Rose. Back in line. Before I do more addition, let me explain something. I am looking for a strong chorus. I need people that look terrific together and that can work together as a group. I have your pictures and resumes, and I know it shows you can, but that's not going to help me. And I don't want to give just a few lines to read. I think it would be better if I knew something about you, about your personalities. So I'm going to ask you some questions. I want to hear you talk. Treat it like an interview. I just want to hear you talk. Don't think you have to perform. Just be yourselves. Everybody, relax. As much as you possibly can. Number 23, Celeste.
How many people do you want?
4 and 4.
44?
No, 4 and 4.
Oh, okay.
4 boys and 4 girls.
Need any women?
Okay, Ellie, I'll start with you.
Me? Don't you want to start at the end?
No, I want to start with you and relax.
I could if you started at the end. What do you want to know?
Well, what do you want to tell me?
Actually, I'd like to tell you that I'm Ellie and I want you to start at the other end. And I can't think of a thing.
Yeah, sure you can. Why did you start dancing?
Because my sister did. We come from this big family. My grandmother was always hanging out the window, leaning on a little pillow. Because that is what Italian grandmothers do on the windows. I was the last of 12. My oldest sister was the one who started taking dance lessons. My mom would take her every Saturday. She used to take me along, and I liked going.
Ellie, how old are you?
10, but I'm mature for my age.
Me to tell you about myself.
Yeah.
About myself. Well, I have no idea how I turned out as heavenly as I am. I was born at a very young age in the hospital so I could be close to my mother. She was sick at the time, you see.
Are you ready to routine?
Okay. Moving right along. I can tell you about all the exciting and wonderful things that have happened in my life. Or would you rather the truth?
I'll take the truth. Why Baja?
What if I'm next? What if I'm next?
What am I gonna do?
I haven't got a clue.
I gotta think of something.
What does he want? What does he want?
Stories from the past?
My memory's going fast.
What can I say? What should I tell him?
Jump ahead 62 years. Wife at the time wants to go to Mexico on vacation. I'm not sold on going to Mexico, but you gotta please the wife. So I thought I'd give it a shot.
What can I say? What should I tell him?
Cabo Pomo, off the grid, 10 days. Scuba diving, storm coming in. Had to leave town fast. Got off the dirt road and hit the highway, and all of a sudden, bam, just like that, my back BlackBerry is going off like a garbage truck in reverse. Beep, 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 beep. Wife at the time says, you've got 200 emails. I said, ignore it, we're on vacation. And whatever you do, if it rings, ring. Hello? Oh, Tom? Yeah, he's right here. It's your boss. Oh? Yeah, good, great, thanks. What? Reorganized? After 40 years. No longer have a job.
God, I'm a wreck! God, I'm a wreck!
I don't know where to start!
I'm gonna fall apart!
Where are my childhood memories?
Who are the boys?
What were the toys?
How do I begin?
And why am I so thin? What should I say? What can I tell him?
So I said to wife at the time, where's the nearest bar? I need a drink.
You ain't gonna drink this early in the day? It's not like I gotta go to work.
The bar was a place called Smokey's. Got there, had a drink, bought a house and moved.
So Tom, tell me, how'd you end up at Baja Shakespeare?
Soon after the move, a neighbor of mine, Hank, came over and he said, I'm going over to Buena Vista today. We're having a read-through of the local Baja Shakespeare theatrical group. Why don't you come along? And I said, Hank, I don't act, don't want to act, never did act, and don't know anything about Shakespeare. I thought the Barnum Avon was some guy that started a cosmetic company. He said, well, come on over anyway. We need a bartender at intermission. It'll be fun. What else are you gonna do today? And I said, nothing. And he said, well, didn't you do that yesterday? And I said, yeah, but I didn't finish. So I went, and there was like 30 people sitting around the circle, and they had notebooks, and they were reading what I understood to be their lines from this play. And they came to this one scene, and the fellow who was in charge, his name was Bob Currier, he said just to the crowd, he said, how many dead guys do we have in this scene? Somebody answered back three. And he said, well, we need more than that. And he looked right at me, he said, you, who are you and what's your part? I said, I'm Tom and I'm here to tend bar during intermission. He said, no, you're not. You're a dead guy in this scene. That was my first Baja Shakespeare role. I've been a Mexican mariachi, a mafioso, a town drunk, had my first onstage fall of many. A Hawaiian fairy with this big, bright yellow sarong. And it was so wrong. A singing, dancing Irish pirate, Halitosis O'Halloran, at your service. And a medieval minstrel. But the most rewarding role I ever played was a disembodied head, sitting on top of a bale of hay, rolling his eyes.
Okay, Tom.
Thanks.
Thank you.
difficult for me to learn this choreographed dancing. Born to be wild, I took high school drama and the teacher called me a mouse. I sang in choir now in the shower and I don't have fun anymore. My husband left me for another, the second one as well. I cooked and I cleaned and still they left and here I am. And everything is beautiful when I'm dancing.
In my net to see what I could get, like a man just released from indenture. As a catcher of fish and a skipper on boat, I've racked up many a mile. Caught boatloads of fish, but so many I missed. Lessons in my head I did file.
Son of a son, son of a son, son of a son of a sailor. Son of a gun, load the last ton, running ahead of the gale there.
I could see in that near future, my son had the same disorder. He would take to the sea in the footsteps of me and catch fish of the first order.
Haul the sheet in, right on the wind, with windsurfing Baja before us. Riding the waves as the tight rigging sings, it's the son of a gun of the chorus.
Where it all ends, I can't fathom, my friends. If I knew, I might toss out my anchor. So I cruise along, always singing a song. Not a lawyer, a thief, or a banker.
But a son of a son, son of a son, son of a son of a sailor. Son of a gun, load the last ton, running ahead of the gale there.
A line of fishmen, huh? So tell me, how did a fishman get to performing?
Well, how do you think? Kim got me drunk at karaoke night. Next thing I knew, I was in the cast and turned in my bio. Easy to get into Baja Shakespeare, but
impossible to get out.
When the sun beats down and burns the flip flaps off your feet, and your ass is so hot from sitting on the quad seat, come down to Smokey in old LB. Yeah. On a barstool with my baby is where I'll be. Now let's Smokey's
out of the sun.
Now let's Smokey's
get in the bus.
People
falling in love.
It's Smokies.
It's like heaven above.
It's Smokies.
Smokehouse!
Now that the smoke is out of the sun, now that smoke is, I'll be getting above. Now that smoke is, I'll be falling in love. Now that smoke is, it's like heaven above. Baja Shakespeare, Shakespeare.
Yes, sir, Mr. Zach. My full name is Jefferson Thaddeus Everett Haycock, but my stage name is Ricky Royal. Do you like it?
Very cute.
Well, my mom thinks it sounds like a real Shakespearean actor, you know, a thespian. Well, I grew up in Central Ohio near Columbus, and the neighbor taught theater at the university, and whenever they needed children, they would always ask the faculty kids first. I had my first role when I was only 8 years old. I was one of 12 Siamese children in the King. Do you remember Yul Brynner as the king? Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Well, you're a little too young. But he was fabulous. At age 12, I was in Richard III. That was my first tragedy. The role of Richard was played by a professional actor from New York City, Stéphane Guiroche. I mean, I saw him on TV about a week after the play was over on Bonanza. Freaking Bonanza. I mean, this guy was a star, a real star, and I thought, hey, I could be too. You know, I played the Duke of York, and I was murdered by Richard in the Tower of London, but I came back as a ghost to haunt him in his sleep. Dream on, thy cousin smothered in the tower. Let us be laid within thy bosom, Richard, and weigh thee down to ruin, shame, and death. Thy nephew's souls bid ye despair and die. I had the passion, but not the courage. I was scared, you know. Then I moved to Chicago, and I met this great gal, my Ruby, and now we're engaged. Hey, thanks. You know, I'm mostly here just helping her get her foot into the Baja Shakespeare Company, but then I started hearing that this esteemed acting troupe was, well, you know,
a party every night.
But they promised me that this year it was going to be different. This year was going to be true Shakespeare. But in the words of Yul Brynner, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Well, just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a Baja trip that started back in Ohio and ended in the Shakespeare skit. A friend and I were scouting out a place to bring my bride. He split and left me high and dry, abandoned without a ride.
Abandoned without a ride.
Two huge duffels, a half-eaten burrito, a canteen of water, and a huge box of Mexican tchotchkes. Holy shit! I was looking for an acting troupe where my true love would excel. The Baja Shakespeare Company would serve that purpose well. So
would
I built
serve that purpose well.
So I built our dream in old LB, this tiny Baja jewel with pickleball and kiting too. Mountains and the shore. Open mic and the Shakespeare Company,
where we'll all recite the bar.
You know, he drove off and left me. He really did. He even dumped my beautiful Mexican sink in a box of tile. I mean, what a freaking asshole. Well, I grabbed all my stuff and dragged it up the road to this little white building on the corner, and they handed me a bus schedule. I'm going, holy crap, you know, I was looking around the back room to see if they needed a remodel bathroom, because I had a really nice sink and matching tile. But you know what? That little town was Los Barriles. And that little white building on the corner was Baja Properties. So I built our little dream casita, the bathroom sink first, and brought down my ruby. You know, Baja Shakespeare. We can do that. We will do that.
Very good. And you, Ruby?
Oh, no, me?
Yeah, you, Ruby.
That's what he said.
Well, oh God, I don't know where to begin.
Tell him how you got started.
Okay, well, everybody said that when I was little, that when they turn on the radio, I'd just get up and I'd start dancing. And then one day, this man came around to our house selling,
lessons.
Lessons, that's right. Oh, he was a very good salesman. I'll never forget it. He took me and he put me up against the television set, you know, one of those big square things. And then he took my foot and he put it up against the back of my head and he goes, well, this little girl could be a star. Well, I don't know if it's the look on my face or the fact that I wouldn't let go of his leg. But we didn't have a lot of money. My dad was in the Navy and my mom was a stay-at-home mom. But she knew how much it meant to me. So she signed me up for those lessons at the Dorothy B. Gladys School of Dance. Well, from that moment on, I watched everything on television, any kind of dancing on it, especially on Sunday nights. It was the
Ed Sullivan.
Right, Ed Sullivan. Every Sunday, like church. I'm sorry, I'm just so terribly nervous.
That's all right. Just take a minute and pour yourself together.
Yeah.
For her, this is together.
Yeah, he's right. But I always knew what I wanted to be. I wanted to be one of those people in the movies. Funny thing is, though, I didn't want to be Ginger Rogers. I wanted to be Bette Midler. Except for one small
problem.
See, I really couldn't sing. I could never really sing. What I couldn't do is
sing.
I could never hold a
note.
It goes all around my
throat.
Is it terrifying?
Sing.
I could never see your note was lower or was
higher.
Which is why I disappear. My friends say, let's start a
choir.
When I begin to
shriek,
it's a cross between
shriek.
And a quiver or
moan.
It's kind of like a
croak
or a record player.
Broke.
What it doesn't have is
tone.
And I know you're thinking, what a crazy
ding-a-ling.
But see, I really couldn't
sing.
I could never really
sing.
What I couldn't do is
sing. Three blind mice.
Three blind mice! Oh, it's not intentional.
She's doing her best. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Jingle bells, jingle bells! Oh, it blows my mind.
She gets depressed.
Oh, but what I lack in pitch, I make up for in
power!
Which is why all my friends say I'm perfect for the shower. Still, I'm terrific at it.
Dance.
Men are coming in there.
Pants.
I'm a birdie on a
wing.
And when I become a
chirp,
it's a
who's a little twerp?
There's a little twerp going pong instead of
bang.
And at Christmas time when all my friends go
caroling,
it's so disheartened.
Ning.
So disquiet.
Ting.
So discouraged.
Jing.
Honey, please stop answering.
Ring.
But see, I really couldn't
sing.
I could never really
sing.
What I couldn't do was sing.
Four foot ten. That's the story of my life. I remember when everyone was my size in like sixth grade. That was great. And then everyone else started moving on up, and there I am, stuck at
4'10".
I kept hoping and dreaming. I used to hang from the parallel bars by the hour, hoping I'd stretch just an inch more, because I was into dance then, and I was good. I even went out for cheer. You know what they told me? No dice, kid. Y'all get lost on the football field. The pom-poms are bigger than you. I spent my whole childhood waiting to grow taller than
4'10".
I kept hoping and dreaming. Let's face it, I'm never gonna be Maria Tallchief. I'm just this prancing peanut. In my last show, they cast me as a 10-year-old brat.
Ten.
Oh, sorry, Ellie. I mean, my whole trip, my whole life's been about my size, and it still is. But I guess I shouldn't complain. I mean, from the time I was a kid of five till now, I've always worked. I've never stopped dancing.
Okay, thank you, Donna. John,
Johnny B is my stage name, number 44. Special talents, juggling. Mouse trumpet. singing and standing on my head. I came here about 30 years ago just for the windsurfing, and I'm one of the last old windsurfer guys on the block now, but something you may not know about me is I played rugby for a school team in New Zealand, and I spent a lot of time in the scrum. Well, beat the drum and hold the phone. The sun came out today. We're born again. There's new grass on the field. Crossing the 20 and headed for the goal is a brown-eyed, handsome man. Anyone can understand the way I feel. Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play today. Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play today. Look at me. I can beat second five. After my first year of college, I knew I didn't want a desk job, so I stuck out my thumb, hitched a ride up to Alaska, got a job on a fishing boat. That ride took me all the way to where I'm at today.
Okay, Oksana, you're good next.
Good luck, girl. You got this. Go.
Hello.
Hello. Can we start?
Such a big stress. Hello. My name is Oksana. Oksana Leonidovna Lushko. I was born in Ukraine. It was Soviet Union at that time. It was okay. We were poor, but we were happy. And then I moved to Moscow. And that was perestroika time. That was very fun. Believe me. We were young, we were so crazy about all those changes, and we worked hard, and we built new country, and we worked hard, and be busy, and we started to have everything what we wanted. But I don't know, not really happy. And cold. You know, always cool. Then I moved to Spain. That was very good. That was warm. And then I moved here, and that's even better. Because it's summer all year round, and yes, I love it. And here I am. With summer, but I'm new here, and I don't really know what to do next. So my friend Ginger, she told me that there is a theater here, and I can come. I can meet people. Hello, hi, hi, and I can do something. So here I am. I can sing. I can read, I see all people singing here. I can sing also, but I don't know your English songs. What about this one? Muy famosa canto, English. Very famous song in my country. Marusa!
This is not what we need.
like it. Капуста глаз морозит, капает слезы, капает слезы.
What is this?
Song.
Vita, can you read something?
My stage name is Oksana.
Oh yes, Oksana. Can you read something?
Yes, I can read, but I can read.
Однажды, студеную зимнюю пору, я из лесу вышел. Был сильный мороз, гляжу, поднимается медленно в гору лошадка.
I'm sorry, but no one can understand a word you're saying.
Do you think I understand you?
Please just give her a chance.
For you. This better be good.
On the dot. Thank you.
Quickly when I knew I
this brotherhood of man, whatever that means. And so I cry sometimes when I'm lying in bed, just to get it all out, what's in my head. And I am feeling a little peculiar. And so I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high. And I scream the top of my lungs, what's going on? And I said,
hey!
Baja Shakespeare's stage name is Sir Loin Olivier. When I was a kid, I was, I was shy and sensitive. I was. Now that I look back at my youth, I see a little guy, 12 years old, with a ton of energy. So much so that everybody thought I had ADHD, whatever the heck that was. Got put on a drug and took it for a year and said, no more. Well, 10 years later, the Vietnam War took off and they didn't want me. I lost a lot of friends, but I'm still here. In this next production of A Midsummer Night's Chorus Line, I would like to audition for the role of Oberon, King of the Fairies.
That role is taken. You'll have to play the role of Titania, Queen of the Fairies.
I can play a woman. Where's Colleen, the costume goddess?
Here I am. I've made many men into women.
Really? All you need to play Titania is tits and ass. Got myself a fancy pair. Lightened up the derriere. Did the wig with it. Got the gig with it. Tits and ass. Did the bingo bongo gun. Presently I'm getting East Cape tours. Tits and ass. Can't change your life. They sure
tomorrow, and you'll find
down.
Zach, can the kids sit down now?
Yeah, and smoke. Can the adults please go smoke?
You're all
smoking. Right, everybody take 10. And you, alcohol is changed.
Here we go.
Cassie, stay on stage, please.
Well, this audition certainly is interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
What do you mean? I have to be here. It's your production. Your vision, Zach.
To the chorus?
Well, sure, I'd love a starring role, but I'll take what I can get.
You stand out in chorus cast. For featured, you stop two shows cold. You're a born prima donna.
That's my problem, Zach. I don't fit in, and I can't keep a job. All my friends, my adoring fans, they all tell me I'm a star, but I don't come close to shining like a real star. Give me a chance, Zach. Give me somebody to sing for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So you're going through some self-reflection now. It happened to all of us. Something happened.
That's what I kept telling myself when I ran off to Cabo, but I don't have confidence. There I was, this little fish in the big aquarium that's Los Cabos, and I was lost.
You didn't work out there?
Sure, I worked. I led karaoke for Squid Row during happy hour. And, well, there was a revolving door of bands that I tried to get into, but they always let me go. Let's face it, Zach, without you, I can't perform, even at La Fagata's open mic. But in Cabo, I got on a Cabo Mill radio. You deserve a break today, so get out and get away to Pueblo Bonito. It's a timeshare jingle. Isn't that something? But, well, gosh, you must have heard about...
Yeah, I did hear that you hooked up with some Sammy Hagar knockoff band. Getting a bit wild, running around, carrying on.
Yeah, I don't do groovy well. You would think, though, that I'm a woman of leisure, that I could perfect my inner confidence and perfect my wild side. Gosh, I gotta talk to Celeste about that. Truth is, though, in Cabo, I was just getting fat and lazy or dizzy and crazy, which is why I came back to find you, Zach, because I need you to remind me to have something that I can believe in, to have someone to be. Use me, choose me. I know, I stand out. It's just that I want to fly.
Oh, look, sugar. If you want to fly, why don't you try kiteboarding?
Oh. Zach, do you really need me to say it again? I'm looking to be your reflection, and I need direction, so yeah, I'm putting myself on the line. I'm putting myself on your line. Don't teach others to do what I should be doing myself. I'm a performer, so let me sing for you. Give me somebody to sing for. Give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin. Thank you.
can't go back to the chorus, Cassie. That's not the answer.
I'm not looking to go back. I'm looking to start over, and I'll settle for that. Starting over?
Starting over? We can't.
What? We? You're talking about...
No, I'm not.
Yeah, I think you are. You're talking about us. Our Midsummer Night's Dream.
No, I'm not. Let's just keep this business, Cassie, okay?
Oh, of course. So sorry.
You shouldn't have came. You don't fit in.
But I did once, and I can do it again. You're not going to let me try. Come on, Zach. Give me another chance.
Excuse me, Zach. You ready for the troop to come back in now?
Yeah. Bring them in. Bring them in, and Cassie, stand learn the lyrics.
Everybody in, here we go, come on. All right, we're using hats. Everybody grab a hat, try to find one that fits.
Did you get the hats? All right, let's review this. It's the same combination we worked on earlier. It also goes with the lyrics you just learned. Now, this is important. I want to hear unison singing and unison dancing. You must blend. This is one of those numbers where you back the star. You are her friend. I don't want anyone to pull my attention. Now, let's review this. Starting position in third. Hips and shoulders on diagonal. Elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready. Let's do it face away from the mirror. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Excuse me, but after the grapevine, does the house hat come down on 2?
Yes, hat's on 2.
When does the hat go up?
It's on 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
All right, listen. Ginger has the style I'm looking for, very 30s. Everybody keep your eye on her. Let's do it in groups. Let me see the girls in the line. Tallest girls in the center, shorter girls on the end.
Wait, I need a hat.
Here, Cassie.
Oh.
All right. 5, 6, 7, 8.
1.
You're late.
Singular sensation. Every little step she takes.
Straight one leg, Sheila.
1. Thrilling combination. Every move that she makes.
Don't pop her head, Cassie.
1 smile and suddenly nobody else will do.
Keep making sure.
You know you'll never be lonely.
Dance in the chorus line. You're unique.
I came back to blend in and seek balance. So I'm volunteering and I'm doing yoga and I even rescued a scruffy dog.
Cassie, you can't do it.
But I did. I did the routine like everybody else.
I know. And to be perfectly honest with you, I couldn't stand it. Why did you leave?
Oh. So we are going to get into that?
Why did you leave me? I came home one night and you were gone.
You'd left me weeks before.
Left? I thought we were living together.
More like cohabitating. In reality, you'd fallen in love again.
Fallen in love again? I was working my first play. You know it. I was working my first play.
I know, and that's when we made magic together. But then the stage became your entire existence, and you were madly in love with it enough to create the only thing that means anything to you. Doing it all, directing plays and staging the choreography and creating musicals. Zach, I worshipped your passion, but I missed being your muse, and I want that again.
Yeah, I guess you do.
Oh, Zach, I want to be part of your world again. I want to go through the steps, learn to do the dance with you, and know your routine. I can handle that. It's not being your inspiration that got to me, and not being able to keep up, because that's what you expected. You're moving up in the world, and you wanted me to be right there with you. I know you did. I mean, that was good, but you wanted me to be a star.
Hey, Cassie, what's the matter with that? What's wrong with that? What's wrong with being the best you can be?
God, good, better, best. How can you sustain it?
So, that is what you really want from me? This is really what you want to do?
Yes. I'd be proud to be one of them. You're wonderful.
Cassie, you're special.
Oh, Zach, you're all special. He's special, and she's special, and John and Sheila and Rose, they're all special. And I'd be happy to be dancing with them. And I'll take chorus, if you'll take me.
Okay, Zach. Who are we going to hire?
I don't know.
Well, what do you want to do now?
Match them up and teach. Do the tap combination.
Okay, everybody, the tap combination. Question, Celeste?
Ginger, I was just stretching.
Okay. All right, tap combination. William, my protege, will be demonstrating the first step of the tap combination, Baja Shakespeare style.
Easy, kids, easy. Step, ball, change, step, ball, change, step, ball, change. Swing your partner for a while, doing it Bosch Shakespeare style.
All right, Mr. Intrepid. Not bad, not bad at all. Everybody else! 5, 6, 7, 8!
God, when this is over, do I need a drink?
What am I doing in show business?
All right, everybody, stage right, please. I'm going to put you into groups. Okay, give me, let's see, Kiki, Donna, Ruby, and Vita.
My stage name is Oksana.
I'm sorry, Oksana. Smile, honey. And 5, 6, 7, 8. Stay on the beat. Let me see some smiles. Not that phony self smile. I want to see that I love to dance smile. Kiki, I'm not hearing any taps.
No taps.
Okay. Stage left, please. Next group. Give me Celeste and Shelley.
You don't remember my name? Ellie.
Oh. Sorry, Ellie. And William, where are you? Are you hiding back there? You should know this by now. Come on out.
I'm still a work in progress.
Ginger, tapping isn't my strongest point.
No worries. Okay, I want Johnny B and Tom. Others, hold on. Boys, stay upstage to the girls. Celeste, relax. Enjoy it. And 5, 6, 7, 8.
John! Shit! Oh, Tom!
Celeste!
Hey, what are you doing? Hey,
I'm just helping him up here, man. Tom! Oh, man.
Tom, are you okay? Did you hurt yourself?
It'll be all right.
It's not your knee, is it?
Is it your ankle? Did you pull a muscle?
I think I just twisted something.
Oh. Well, who's your doctor?
I don't need a doctor.
Call the East Cape Clinic.
Yeah, that's it.
Call these kids.
Okay.
Better get them up.
Yeah, let's get them up.
All right. Ready?
One, two, three. Oh!
Does anybody have a painkiller?
Oh, I do.
Hey.
I've got Valium.
Okay. Give us water.
Hang in there, buddy.
You're going to be okay, Tom.
Yeah, okay, but without a job.
Look, I don't think you should give him that. You don't know what's wrong.
Oh, please. I've had three already today.
Jack, I spoke to the clinic, and they said it'd be quicker if we got him on a quad and over to the clinic.
Okay.
They'll be waiting for him at the emergency entrance.
Okay, okay.
I'll go.
No, I'll go. Thanks, Rocco.
Okay.
Let me
get him. All right.
Tom, you're going to be okay.
Yeah.
Call me when you get to the clinic.
Yeah.
What do you do when you can't perform anymore?
Kill yourself.
No, really. What do you do when you can't perform anymore?
Oh, shit. What kind of a question is that?
Real heavy.
Yeah, man.
What do you do? What are you going to do when you can't perform anymore?
Well, I'll tell you, because I'm getting scared. I love being in this business, but one day it hits you. Johnny, you've been having fun at this for almost 20 years now, but where's it getting you?
You know, you're right. A lot of people are feeling that way, and they're starting to leave Baja Shakespeare one by one.
There's no security in performing.
But wait a second.
No promotion, no advancement.
But wait a minute, John. You've had a ton of great roles.
Listen, if you're looking for that kind of security, forget it.
It's not just that.
Well, what then?
I could do without that, but look, we're getting old here. How much longer can we keep this up?
Tell me about it.
It's true.
Well, sure it is, but isn't this happening to all of us? At least we're still up here making fools out of ourselves.
Oh, please, I don't want to hear how Baja Shakespeare's dying. Because I just got here.
Don't worry, honey, it's not.
Well, they're not doing big Shakespeare productions like they used to. But even if they do Shakespeare, even if you get a role, it's gonna close one day.
Yeah, nothing lasts forever.
Yeah, sure.
She's right.
That's just the way it is.
And then you have to start all over again, because the only chorus line you can depend on in this business is the one at Social Security.
Hit it, Johnny. But don't you want to be in more than just the chorus line?
Gee, I just wanted to get in one.
Well, you know, I'd like to be more than just the tall, skinny, redhead second from the end. Not that I want to be a star or anything.
Hell, I do.
Oh, heck, everybody in the whole damn country wants to be a star.
Okay, I admit, I want to be the next J-Lo.
But she dances.
I know, don't you just love her?
But what I want to know is what are you going to do when you can't perform anymore?
Oh, who cares? I don't care if I never dance another step in my life. I'd be happy going to Hollywood and replacing Nicole Kidman. Big deal, right? Well, a girl can dream, can't she?
Kiki, your dreams aren't going to pay your rent.
Well, I'll find someone who can. Hey, lady guy.
Hey.
Yeah. Well,
the thing is, a gal can always get married.
She didn't say anything about marriage.
And another thing.
Oh, I don't know. I just can't take it anymore.
Well, these bodies aren't going to last forever.
Yep, I can't take it.
We're no better off than athletes.
Well, I'm sorry. I can't think about this right now. Because I'm going to kick those legs as long as I can. And when I can't, well, I will just do something else.
You could sell real estate right here in Los Angeles.
You'll be fabulous. Or I can make dresses and open boutique and call it Sunny Dresses.
Or real estate where you could finally get paid to act.
Oh, that's good.
I mean, it sure beats shaking.
shaking your tushy in the theater for 7 performances, and I hear the market's hot right now.
Oh, come on. I don't have the patience for that.
Listen, none of us got into this for the money or the security. We're all here because we want to be here, and you're acting like it's just another job, but it's not. So what are y'all talking about?
Darling, we're talking about life. That's why, for me, it's one day at a time. That's plenty enough for me.
Hey, we all feel the same way, or we wouldn't be here. But I got someone special I want to spend time with. You know, I love the theater, but it's all about creating balance in your life and just enjoying retirement.
Yes.
Tell me, what are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Oh, man. You know,
what do you want to do?
I'd love to stay in the business, you know, create something on my own. I could write or try directing, you know, play guitar and sing with these guys at open mic. You know, just cross some things off the bucket list. Hey, who wants to go to Copper Canyon with me and Ruby?
Oh, I do!
And me if my health's still good.
I can't think of anything else I'd rather do.
Oh, hi, sweetheart, you're young. You go for it, okay?
Well, if you had to pick something else, another career, any other career, what would you pick? Go on, pick any other career. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Young.
Hey, what do you want to be when you grow up? Sheila, what do you want to be? You can be anything you want. Maybe Al will help you. Sarah, what do you want to be when you grow up? She wants to be me. Well, that's very easy. Di, hiding there on the end. What do you want to be when you grow up?
A grown up.
Well, you're getting there. Any day. Jerry, what do you want to be?
I want to get out of rehab.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I know that one day, whatever show I'm in is going to close, and I'm finally going to be able to get off my diet, and I'm going to get a place in Los Barriles with the lighting guy, and I'm going to get really good at pickleball, which will take some time, and I'm going to dance wildly around my kitchen while someone else cooks and just enjoy getting fat.
Oh, that sounds great, all except for the getting fat part. I could do that while sipping on a margarita.
Yeah. Listen, I just want to be happy.
Aw, come on. You're not happy? Look, I sit around and get depressed and think about those things too. But then I meet somebody, and they say to me, oh, you perform with Baja Shakespeare? That's cool. I'd love to do that, but I'm not brave enough. And I get this feeling inside because I remember when I used to watch you old timers. And I used to think, I'll never get to do Shakespeare or perform with you all. But deep down inside, I knew I would. And God damn it, I've come this far, and right. I'm not giving up now.
Yeah, that's what I used to say. That I gotta be a dancer by the time I'm 18. And then I found out I should be in musical comedy chorus, and I thought, I better have a main part by the time I'm 21.
No, you did that too? Gave yourself a time limit?
Oh, I still do it. Oh.
Yeah, I mean, how many years do I have left to be a chorus cutie? 3, 4 if I get my eyes done. But I don't want to deal with it on that level. So just lately, I've been thinking about teaching acting. I don't know. Am I copping out? Am I growing up? I don't know.
Who does? Look, how does anyone know? It's just something we are going to have to wait and see.
Rose, tell me, if today were the day that you had to stop performing, how would you feel?
Kiss today goodbye. Wish me luck the same to you.
words I'd like to say before I start eliminating. I think that each and every one of you are absolutely terrific. You've been incredibly wonderful about going through all of this today. Unfortunately, I cannot hire each and every one of you. Ginger?
Will the following people please step forward? William? Ruby?
Rocco! Donna! Sheila! Celeste! Frontline! Thank you! Thank you very much, but I'm sorry. Damn.
Oh, I'll wave you outside.
Oh, love you. I'll be right out.
Ginger, would you join us now? Kiki, I'm sure you'll be fine playing a man for the role.
Oh, yeah. I am your Baja Shakespeare man.
Good. Rehearsal began January 15th. We'll rehearse for 6 weeks. Dress rehearsals are March 7th and 8th. Our Los Barrios opening will be March 9th. Get your contact information and conflict to Cindy. Colleen will get your measurement. Also, bios are due February 1st. And I'm so very glad we will be working together. Thank you for coming.
You'll never be lonely.